Hello student, welcome back to our channel Neat Mantra. So student, in this video we are going to have a quick revision of topic glycolysis and after that we will solve some important question of this topic. So watch this video till the end.
So student, glycolysis is the sequence of reaction that convert glucose into pyruvate. It contains 10 steps and at each step there is involvement of an enzyme. So we look at all these steps and the enzyme involved in it. The reaction start with the 6 carbon compound known as glucose, in which we convert glucose into glucose 6-phosphate with the expenditure of a single ATP and with the help of enzyme hexokinase. Then we isomerize glucose 6-phosphate into fructose 6-phosphate with the help of enzyme phosphoglucose isomerase. Then we convert fructose 6-phosphate into fructose 1,6-bisphosphate with the expenditure of a single ATP and by the help of enzyme phosphofructokinase. Then we break fructose 1,6-bisphosphate with the help of enzyme aldolase into 2-3 carbon containing compound. One is ketose dihydroxyacetone phosphate and one is aldose glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. Now up to this level, the preparatory phase of this reaction is over. In the preparatory phase, we invest energy and the second phase which is starting now is payoff phase in which we obtain energy. So the reaction will continue from this pathway. The glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate will convert into 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. So now we have here two molecule of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate because DHAP or dihydroxyacetone phosphate will isomerize into glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate with the help of enzyme triose phosphate isomerase. So all this reaction will take place twice. So I put 2x at starting of everyone. So we convert glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate into 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. It is also known as 1,3-bisphosphoglyceric acid and these terms can be used interchangeably. And this is done with the help of enzyme glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase. And at this step there is generation of one NADH2 molecule. So this reaction is taking place twice. So here we generate two NADH2 molecules. Then we convert 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate into phosphoglycerate kinase by the help of phosphoglycerokinase into 3-phosphoglycerate. And at this step, one ATP is generated. So this reaction is taking place twice. So two ATP are generated here. Then we convert 3-phosphoglycerate into 2-phosphoglycerate with the help of enzyme phosphoglyceromutase. Then 2-phosphoglycerate is converted into phosphoenol pyruvate with the help of enzyme enolase and a water molecule is removed. So this reaction is taking place twice. So two water molecule are removed here. Then phosphoenol pyruvate is converted into pyruvate with the help of pyruvate kinase and one ATP molecule is generated here. So this reaction is taking place twice. So 2 ATP is generated here. So in this total reaction we generate 4 ATP and we spend 2 ATP. So the net gain of ATP is 2 ATP and we also get 2 NADH2 molecules which will be converted into 6 ATP later on.
So student, now we discuss some NCERT based objective question from this topic glycolysis. You can comment your answer. I will give you time for that. So our first question is, which of the following enzyme catalyzes the first step of glycolysis? Hexokinase, pyruvate kinase, glucokinase, phosphofructokinase first. So the right answer to this question is option A, hexokinase. You will find this question very easy because you just revised the topic. Next question we see, what is the general term used for the anaerobic degradation of glucose to obtain energy? Anabolism, oxidation, fermentation, metabolism. Comment your answer, student. So the right answer to this question is option C, fermentation. Next question we have, when the cell's ATP supply is depleted, which of the following enzyme activity is increased? Options are hexokinase, pyruvate kinase, glucokinase, phosphofructokinase first. So the right answer to this question is option D, phosphofructose kinase first. Phosphofructose kinase first is a regulatory enzyme and it is the major point of regulation in glycolysis. Its activity is increased whenever the cell's ATP supply is depleted. Next question we see, the cleavage of fructose 1,6 biphosphate yields dash 2 aldose, 2 ketoses, an aldose and a ketose. Option D, only a ketose. You can comment your answer. So the right answer is an aldose and a ketose. One is DHAP and other is G3P. Dihydroxyacetone phosphate is rapidly and reversibly converted to dash glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate, fructose 1,6-biphosphate, fructose 6-phosphate. Students, comment your answer. So the right answer to this question is option A, glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. Which is the first step in the payoff phase of glycolysis? Reduction of 1,3-biphosphoglycerate to glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, oxidation of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate to 1,3-biphosphate glycerate, reversible conversion of dihydroxyacetone phosphate to glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, irreversible conversion of dihydroxyacetone phosphate to glyceraldehyde 3-phosphates. You can comment your answer. So the right answer to this question is option B. As I earlier told you in the explanation in the revision of glycolysis about the payoff phase, the first reaction is oxidation of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate to 1,3-bisphosphate glycerate. Next question we see, which substrate is used in the last step of glycolysis? Glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, pyruvate, phosphoenol pyruvate, 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. You can comment your answer. So in the last step, the substrate is phosphoenol pyruvate. So the right answer is option C. Next we see, high concentration of glucose 6-phosphate is inhibitory to hexokinase, pyruvate kinase, glucokinase, phosphofructokinase first. You can comment your answer. So the right answer to this question is option A, hexokinase. Feedback inhibition is a form of allosteric regulation. This product goes and binds to allosteric site of the enzyme and inhibits its activity. So glucose 6-phosphate binds to the allosteric site of hexokinase and inhibits its activity, and it is known as feedback inhibition or allosteric regulation. Next question we see, the product formed in the first substrate level phosphorylation in glycolysis is dash pyruvate, 3-phosphoglycerate, 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate, 2-phosphoglycerate. You can comment your answer. So the right answer to this question is option B, 3-phosphoglycerate. Next question we see, glycolytic pathway regulation involves allosteric stimulation by ADP, allosteric inhibition by ATP, feedback or product inhibition by ATP, and or all of the above. You can comment your answer. So the right answer is all of the above. We see allosteric stimulation by ADP in glycolytic pathway, allosteric inhibition by ATP too, or and feedback or product inhibition by ATP2. Next question we see, during Stirner's exercise, the NADH formed in glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase reaction in skeletal muscle must be reoxidized to NAD+ if glycolysis is to continue. The most important reaction involved in the reoxidation of NADH is dihydroxyacetone phosphate converted to glycerol 3-phosphate, glucose 6-phosphate converted to fructose 6-phosphate, isocitrate converted to alpha-ketoglutarate, pyruvate converted to lactate. You can comment your answer. So the right answer to this question is option D, pyruvate is converted into lactate. NADH does donate H plus to pyruvate to produce lactic acid and become NAD or get oxidized. Next question we see, which of these cofactors participate directly in most of the oxidation reduction reaction in the fermentation of glucose to lactate? ADP, ATP, FAD / FADH2, NAD plus / NADH. You can comment your answer. So the right answer to this question is option D, NAD plus / NADH. This is the cofactor which is directly involved in many oxidation reduction reaction in the fermentation of glucose to lactate. Next question we see, during glycolysis ATP and MG plus 2 coenzymes function 4 phosphoglyceraldehyde, 3 phosphate dehydrogenase, 4 pyruvic kinase, 4 phosphoglucoisomerase, 4 glucokinase. You can comment your answer. So the right answer to this question is option D, 4 glucokinase. So glucokinase is a type of hexokinase only found in liver cells and beta pancreatic cell, and it do not have any feedback effect of G6P. Next we see, total ATP production during EMP pathway is 8 ATP molecules, 10 ATP molecules, 16 ATP molecules, 20 ATP molecules. You can comment your answer. So the right answer to this question is option A, 8 ATP molecules. 4 ATP is formed in the payoff phase and 6 ATP is regenerated from 2 NADH molecule. So total gain is 10 ATP and 2 ATP are lost in preparatory phase. So the net gain is 8 ATP. So the answer is 8 ATP molecules. Next question we see, during anaerobic condition the rate of glycolysis, a word is missing here, increases. So you have to read the question. During anaerobic condition the rate of glycolysis increases is called Warburg effect, Pasteur effect, Hill reaction, compensation point. You can comment your answer. So the right answer to this question is option B, Pasteur effect. The increase of rate of glycolysis in absence of O2 is due to the non-availability of those enzymes which are easily available in presence of O2, and it is also known as Pasteur effect. Next question we see, in glycolysis during oxidation electrons are removed by ATP, molecular oxygen, glyceraldehyde, 3-phosphate, NAD+. So the right answer to this question is option D. Oxidation of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate into 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate lead to production of NADH molecule, or you can say NADH2 plus molecule. Next question we have, a product of glycolysis that is consumed in alcoholic fermentation is CO2, ATP, NADH2. Option D is all of the above. The A is not here, A is here, all of the above, fourth option is. You can comment your answer. So the right answer is option D. So if you have to continue produce ATP from glycolysis, you have to reoxidize NADH2 into NAD+, so that the glycolysis process can go on. Next we see, the reaction of glycolysis are reversible, irreversible, both, none of these. You can comment your answer. So the right answer is both. You can find reversible as well as irreversible reaction in glycolysis. Next question we see, the overall goal of glycolysis Krebs cycle and electron transport system is the formation of ATP in one large oxidation reaction, sugars, nucleic acid, ATP in small stepwise unit. You can comment your answer. So the right answer to this question is ATP produced in small stepwise units. Next question we see, which of the following product are obtained by anaerobic respiration from yeast? Beer and wine, alcohols, CO2, all of these. Very easy question this is. So the right answer to this question is option D. So if you like our video, please share our videos and like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you very much.